Hello, Erwan from MotionVFX. On the previous tutorials, we were focused on the media page and see how to manage and prepare the footage for the editing. In this video, we'll start the edit with the basic editing features. In DaVinci Resolve, there are two dedicated pages for the editing, the cut page and the edit page. We will start with the edit page, as this one is more complete for the advanced editing. Of course, we will cover the cut page later. First, let's have an overview of the interface. The edit page is divided in two parts, the viewer on the top and the timeline below. On the top of the interface, you have access to the panels, like the media pool, where you can get access to your video and audio footage. You will have also access to the FX library, where you can find your video transitions, titles, FX. This is a place where you will be able to find all your content from MotionVFX, like the titles, animations, or FX. Inside the edit index, you will be able to see the list of all the content from your timeline. We will see it in details in the next tutorials. And the last panel is a sound library. As the name suggests, you will be able to create your own library of audio elements, but also the one from Fairlight. This one is free to download and available on the Blackmagic website. To display all the elements, I will type inside the search field **, and I will have access to all the sounds elements available. As you may have noticed, the sound library will take all the height of the interface. If I switch back to the media pool, we'll see that the media pool will also get the complete height of the interface. To get back to the half height, you can click here on the little arrow and the timeline will get back with the full width of the interface. Having the full height can be very useful as you can display more clips for the media pool or you can increase the size of the thumbnails. But having the full height gives you also the possibility to display two panels at once, media pool and the FX library, or media pool and edit index. The only drawback is the fact that you will shrink the timeline part. Before going deep with the media pool, let's have a look at the panel on the right. First, you can open the mixer, where you can manage the volume and the audio effects. You can also display the metadata panel, where you will get all the information you will need about your clip selected in the media pool. A simple way to check quickly the codec, the frame rate, or the resolution of your clip. The last panel is the inspector. With this one, you can get access to all the parameters of the elements you have selected. Video clip, audio, titles, FX. In this example, I can directly modify the parameters from one clip before adding it to the timeline. A good way to correct a clip at the source, so you won't have to do it each time when you add a part of it in the edit. Like on the left, you can ask DaVinci Resolve to display all the inspector with the full height of the interface, so you won't have to scroll up and down to access to all the parameters. And you can also use the full height to display the inspector and the metadata panel at the same time. Okay, let's go back to the media pool and see some cool features for the edit. Inside my media pool, I've got two folders, video and music. You can display the content of each folder in various ways. First, there is a metadata view, which displays the thumbnails and the main metadata of the clip. You can preview the clip content by skimming the clip with the cursor. The second view is the thumbnail view, where you can choose the size of the thumbnails. And the third view is the list view. In this view, you can display and sort the clip with almost all the metadata available for each clip. By doing a right-click on any metadata name, you can decide which metadata are displayed. To show you it in action, I can use the metadata panel and ask to display the shot and scene metadata. In the descriptions category, I will enter close-up. I can ask DaVinci Resolve to display the description category and we can see the close-up metadata. So I can sort this metadata and regroup all the clips with the same description. The list view is really nice, but at the first look, it is complex to see if it is the right clip just by the name or the metadata. There is an option which can help you, show film strip. This option will display a few frames of the clip selected on the top of the list. This is very useful when you want to select a part of the clip, as I can press I to get my in point and O for my out point, and visually I can see my selection. And just below, I can check the duration of the selection, the timecode of the in and out point. You can also do a search by typing the file name of the clip inside the search field. You can do the research with many metadata. There is a second option very useful. I will switch back to the thumbnail view. It will be more obvious. In the media pool, inside the edit page, and only in the edit page, you can ask DaVinci Resolve to display a second media pool. In the option menu, select Dual Pan Media Pool to activate it. So here, I can have access to my video content and audio content at the same time, which is really nice. But also, any content from a smart bin, like the timeline for example. Next, let's see how the viewer works. When you select a clip in the media pool by double-clicking on it, it will be loaded inside the viewer. On the top left, you can see the duration of the clip. On the right, you can see the timecode of the current position of the playhead. You can move inside your clip by moving the playhead viewer. But if you want to play it in real time, you can click on the play button. To be sure to be in real time, check the frame rate indicator. You can stop and play reverse. You can go at the first frame or the last frame of the clip and ask DaVinci Resolve to loop the clip. On the left, you have the jog wheel feature. It will allow you to move quickly inside the clip, very useful when you have a long clip. But the more productive way to navigate inside your clip is to use shortcuts. Of course, you may know the universal shortcuts, spacebar, to play and stop the reading of the clip. But there is a better solution for editing,
JKL. JKL has the three shortcuts to know by heart.
L will play the clip. K will stop the clip.
J will play the clip in reverse.
But there is more, as there are many options available. For example, if you type L once, it will play at a normal speed. If you press L a second time, it will double the speed. If you press L a third time, it will double again it. So, 4 times the original speed. If you want to move slowly inside your clip, you can maintain K and press L at the same time. It will play half the speed. You can see it on the frame rate indicator. JKL are universal as you can use them in almost all the editing softwares available. Talking about shortcuts, I would like to show you how to open the keyboard customizations panel. Inside, you can edit any shortcut, but also you can ask DaVinci Resolve to use shortcuts from other editing softwares, like Adobe Premiere Pro, Apple Final Cut Pro, Avid Media Composer, and Pro Tools. This could be very useful if you are in transitions to Resolve from one of these editing software. For this tutorial, I will stay with the DaVinci Resolve shortcuts. Okay, now we will select a part of this video clip to add it to the timeline. I want to start here, so I will press the I key to set the in point. And for the out point, I would like to end here, so I will press the O key. I can see the duration of my selection here. To go directly to the endpoint, press Shift plus I, and to move to the outpoint, press Shift plus O. At any time you can modify any point, just press the O key again to change the position. To remove an in or out point, just press the Option key plus O, or Option key plus I. Okay. We are done with our selection, let's add it to the timeline. The easiest way to do it is to drag and drop it into the timeline. Automatically, DaVinci Resolve will create a new timeline based on the clip resolution and frame rate. You can see the new timeline inside the media pool. You can quickly check the timeline metadata by clicking inside the thumbnails on the icon on the right. When you select the clip in the timeline, the viewer switches into the timeline. You can see it as the name of the top switched to the name of the timeline. When you work on your edit, it is great to see at the same time the last frame of your edit and the first frame of the next clip you want to add to check if the cut will be correct. With one viewer is not ideal, so you can switch to two viewers by clicking on this icon. So the viewer on the left will be the source viewer and the one on the right will be the record viewer. I will quickly select the second clip and add an in and out point. And I will drag and drop it after my first clip. I will select the third clip and add also an in and out point. But this time, I will show you that if you drag the clip on the record viewer, you will see many options that will appear. Insert, overwrite, replace, fill to fill, place on top, append at end, and ripple overwrite. I will select the first option, insert. It will add my clip at the end of my edit, so that's nice. I will undo this action with Command plus Z. And let's see what will be the behavior if I move the playhead of the timeline between the two clips. As you can see, it will push my second clip to insert my third clip. And you will see that the insert edit is looking not for the clip, but for the position of the playhead. If I move the position in the middle of my second clip, it will divide the second clip in two parts. If I redo the same action with the overwrite option, you can see a new behavior, as this time it will erase the second part. If I use the third option, replace, it will replace the second clip by the third clip. But what is really important with the replace options is to understand how it works. With the two viewers, we can see that the two viewers get the same image, as it should be the out point. In fact, the replace option looks only the position of the playhead in the source viewer, and the position of the playhead in the timeline. Replace doesn't care of the in and out point inside the source viewer. It will sync the two playhead. For example, if I move the playhead of the source to the in point, Shift plus I, and perform a replace, we can see that in the timeline, we'll get content before the in point. So when you are using the replace feature, be aware of the position of the playhead on the source and on the timeline. Next, fit to fill. For this option, I will select a long range for the source clip. We can see that the duration is around 15 seconds. To know the duration of one clip inside the timeline, just press the F key to perform a match frame. It will load the clip inside the source viewer with the in and out point. We can see that the duration is about 3 seconds. So in this example, I will ask DaVinci Resolve to add my 15 seconds content inside the 3 second content. With the Fit to Fill option, DaVinci Resolve will adapt the speed of the source content to fit inside the record content. In this example, it will increase the speed by 5 to get all the content inside. We can see that there is a change of the speed with this icon. We can do the invert. If my source clip is shorter around 1 second, and if I perform again a Fit to Fill, it will slow down my original clip by 3 to fill the 3 seconds of the clip in the timeline. For the next option, it's really simple, as it will place any element over the one on the timeline. The position of the playhead in the timeline will set the position of the source clip. This option is very useful for titles or graphics. The Append to End option will add your clip at the end of the edit, whatever what the timeline playhead is set. Again, very useful option when you need to quickly create a basic editing. The last option, Ripple Overwrite, will look at the position of the playhead inside the timeline to select which clip will be replaced, and depending on the duration of the source clip, will affect the global duration of the edit by moving all the content after it. As you may notice, dragging and dropping are not the most productive gesture. You can go faster by clicking on the icons for the Insert, Overwrite and Replace features, but you don't have access to all the options available. The most productive way is to use the shortcuts. You can find them in the Edit menu, and this is the best way to level up your productivity. After those elemental notions for editing, in the next tutorial we will go further by adding sounds and effects. See you there, ciao ciao, bye bye.